Hi guys, welcome back to another video of Easy Tutorials. Today in this video, we will create this web page that you can see on my computer screen. Here we have this top navigation bar with one menu icon, then logo. After that, we have some menu link and there is a button at the right corner. In the left side, you can see one lamp with the light. In the right side, you can see this text and one button. Let's click on this button and it will turn off this light. You can see this light gets turned off. Let's click it again and it will turn on this light. And we will create this web page using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. So let's start this video. Here I have this folder and in this folder I have created one HTML file, one CSS file and there is one more folder called images and in this one we have some images, one logo and one menu icon. I will put the images download link in the video description so that you can download and make this web page. Now I will open this folder with my code editor, which is VS Code Editor. So here I have created the HTML file with the basic HTML structures and this one is the CSS file. I have connected the HTML and CSS file with this line of code. Next we will add code in the body tag that will be displayed on our web page. So first, we will create a div with the class name hero. Now for this one, we will add the CSS properties. So add this class name in the CSS file. And here we will add background. Let's add the background of this color code. After that, we will add min height. It will be 100 VH. Then let's add width. It will be 100%. Color will be FFF, which is white. Then we will add position relative. After adding this, come to the HTML file and open this web page with browser. So you can see this dark color on the complete web page. Now we will create the navigation bar where we will add the images and menu link. Let's come back. Come to the HTML file and here we will create a tag nav. In this nav tag, we will add one image, write the images file path. So first we will add this menu image. And for this one, let's add a class name. Let me add the class name menu img. Now I will duplicate it and here we will add the logo, logo.png, and we will change the class name also. The class name is logo. After adding this, we will add some menu link. So first we will create list ul li, and in this li we will add a tag so that we will create a clickable link. And here we will add the link text, so it is latest. Let's duplicate it and change the link text. After this UL tag, we will add one button. So let's add button tag. And I will add the text, click here. And let's add the button type. It will be button. After adding all these things, let's check the web page. And you can see menu icon, logo and menu link and button. Now we have to align all the contents in the same horizontal line. So let's come back and copy this one nav tag. Write it here. For this one, we will add display flex and align items center. We will add some space from the left side and right side. So we will add the padding, let's say 20 pixel from top and bottom, 8 pixel from left side and right side. Now you can see all the contents in the same horizontal line. Next we will add the CSS properties for each images and link. So let's come back and write this nav. After that, we will copy this class name menu img. Copy this, write it here. For this menu image, we will add width. It will be very small, 25 pixel. Then we will add some space from the right side. So let's add the margin right of 20 pixel. Then we will add cursor pointer. Let's add this nav again, and in this nav we have added logo, so let's add the class name logo, and for this logo we will add width. Let's add the width of 160 pixel, then cursor pointer. Now you can see fixed size for this menu icon and this logo. Next we will add the CSS properties for this list. So just come back and copy this nav. In this nav we have the UL tag. So for this UL we will add flex 1. So it will use the entire available space. Then we will add text align right. After that you can see these menu in the right side and we have some space in the center. Let's come back, write this nav UL again, and in this UL we have added li in the HTML file. So for this list we will add display inline block, list style type it will be none, and after that we will add margin, let's add 0 and 20 pixel. Now it is coming in the same horizontal line. Let's come back, and in this li you can see we have added the a tag, ul li a. So let's add this a tag. For this one we will add text decoration, so it will be none. After that we will add color, so the color will be white. Now it looks good. After adding this we will add the CSS properties for the button. So let's come back, and here we have added the button tag, so just copy this one, write it here. For this button let's add the background. So this is the background color code. Then we will add height, so the height will be 30 pixel, and let's add width 60 pixel. After that we will add border radius, so we will see radius in the left and right side of the button. Then the border radius will be 20 pixel. After that border it will be 0 and outline 0. Let's add cursor pointer. Then let's come back, and you can see this button looks like this one. Next we will remove this text from this button and we will add a circle. Let's come back, and here we have the text. Remove this one and let's add a span. We have added a span open and closing tag within this button. So we will add the CSS for this span. Just come back to the CSS file, write this button again, then write a span, and here we will add display. So display will be block. Then we will add background. Let's add the background 999. Then we will add height and width. So let's add the height of 26 pixel and width also 26 pixel. After that we will add the border radius. . 50% so that it will be circle. Now you can see there is one circle in this button. Next we will add a space in the left side of this circle. So let's come back, and here we will add margin from the left side. Let's add 2 pixel margin like this. Now you can see this button here. After completing this top navigation bar, we will add a lamp image and light image in the left side. So let's come back, come to the HTML file, and after closing of this nav tag, you can see the nav tag is closing here. So let's add a space, and here let's add another div. So let's add a div with the class name lamp container. In this one, we will add one image. So first we will add the lamp image. And let's add a class name lamp. Let's duplicate it, and here we will add the another image, which is light, and we will change the class name. It is light. After that, you can see this lamp image and this light image on the web page. Now let's come back and copy this class name lamp container, write it here. For this one, we will add position absolute. Then we will add top 0, and let's add left. I will add left 22%. Then width, it will be 200 pixel. In this one, we have a class name lamp. So for this lamp, we will set the width. Let's add width of 100%. Now we will move this lamp little bit upward. So let's come back, and here instead of top 0, I'll write top minus 20 pixel. So it will move up. Now it is fine. Next, we will add the CSS properties for this light to position it just below the lamp. Just come back, and here you can see we have the class name light. Copy this one, write it here in the CSS file. For this one, let's add the position absolute. After that, we will add top. Let's add top 100%. Then we will add left 50%. Then we will add transform translate x. It will be minus 50%, so that it will be in center. After that, we will add the width. So let's add the width of 700 pixel. Now it is coming here. We have to move it up. So just come back, and instead of top 100%, I'll add 97%. Now we will move this light little bit left side. So let's come back. Here we will add margin left minus 10 pixel. So it will move left side by 10 pixel. Now the light position is perfect. After that, we have to add some text on the right side of the web page. So let's come back to the HTML file. First, we will add those text in the HTML file. So here we will create another div with the class name text container. And in this one, first we will add a text in H1 that will be a title. So let me add this text. Then we will add a text in p tag. So I will add this text. And then we will add a link. So this is the link text. After adding this, open the web page, and you can see all these text in the left side at this position. Now we will add this title in two lines. So we will add a line break here. So after this text latest, we will add br to change the line. Now you can see it is coming in two lines. Next, we have to change its position. So let's come back and copy this class name text container, write it here. For this text container, first we will set the width. So I'll add max width. It will be 600 pixel. Then let's add margin from the top. I'll add 7%. Then we will add margin from the left side. It is 50%. Now it is coming here. Next, we will add the CSS properties for this title, which is in the H1. So add this class name, then write H1. For this text, we will add the font size. Let's add the font size of 80 pixel. Then we will add font weight. Font weight will be 400. Now this text looks good. Next, we will add the CSS properties for this link, which is in the A tag. Just come back, copy this one, then write A tag. And for this A, let's add text decoration none. Then we will add the background. So let's add the background, this one. After that, we will add padding. Let's add the padding of 14 pixel from top and bottom, and left right will be 40 pixel. You can see changes in the button. Now let's come back, and here we will add display. We will add the display. It will be inline block, and after that we will add color. So the button text color will be white. Let's add the font size. So the font size will be 18 pixel, and we will add some space from the top. For that, we will add margin top 30 pixel. After that, we will add the radius. So let's add border radius of 30 pixel. Now this button looks good. Next, we will add one control button at the bottom right corner. So let's come back, come to the HTML file, and after this A tag, we will add a div. Let's add a div with the class name control. In this one, let's add a P tag, and here we will add 04, duplicate it. It will be 05. Within this, we will add another div with the class name line. And in this line, we will add a span tag, span open and closing tag, like this. Let's check the web page, and you can see 04 and 5 over here. Next, we have to add the CSS properties for this one. So first, copy this class name control, write it here. Here we will add display flex. So all the content will be side by side. Align items will be center. Then we will add justify content. It will be flex end. So it will be on the right side. Then we will add some space from the top. So let's add margin top 150 pixel. So it is coming here. Next, we have to design this div with the class name line. So just copy this line. Here we will add dot control dot line. For this one, we will add width. Let's add the width of 250 pixel. Then we will add height. I will add height 4 pixel. Then let's add the background. It will be white. And after that, we will add margin. Let's add margin. Top and bottom will be 0. And from the left and right side, we will add 20 pixel margin. Then we will add border radius. It will be 2 pixel. Now you can see one line between this text. Next, we have to design this span, which is in this div. So let's come back, copy this one, then write a span. For this span, we will add the width. So let's add the width of 50%. Then we will add height. I will add height 8 pixel. And let's add margin top minus 2 pixel. so it will move up by 2 pixels. Then we will add border radius of 4 pixels. After that, we will add the background. So let's add the background color, this one, and display it will be block. Now you can see it is looking good. Next, we have to hide this light. Right now this light is visible, so we will hide this light first. So let's come back and let's see where we have added the class name light. Here it is. So we will add opacity 0. After that, you can see this light is hidden. Next, we will add the click event, so that if we will click on this button, it will turn on the light and it will also toggle this button. For that, let's come back and come to the HTML file. Here we have this button. So in this button, we will add a onClick event. OnClick equal to, let's add a function name toggle btn. So whenever we will click on this button, it will call this function called toggle btn. And after that, in this btn, we will add one id also. So let's add one space and add the id btn. Now come to the bottom, and before this closing body tag, we will add a script tag where we will add the JavaScript. So let's add a variable with the name VTN, and we will add document.getElementById and write the same ID that we have just created, which is VTN. After that, we have to define the function that we are calling onButtonClick, which is toggleBTN. And here we will add a line of code that will be executed whenever we will click on the button. So you can see, whenever we will click on the button, we have to change the background color of this button, and we will also change the background color of this circle, and we will change the position of this circle. For that, we will use the another class name. So let's come to the CSS file, come to the bottom. Here, let's add a class name called active. And in this active class name, we will add a background. So let's add a background. I will add the background of this color, green. Now we have to add this class name in the button so that it will change the background. So let's come to the HTML file. In this JavaScript, we will add this btn, btn dot class list dot toggle, and here we will add the class name, which is active. You can see the background color is changing whenever we will click on this button. Similarly, we have to add a class name in this span also, so that we can change the background color of this span and we can change its position. Let's come back, come to the CSS file, and here we will add the active, and in this one we have the span. So write a span. For this one, we will add the background. So the background will be white, and we will add margin from the left side. So let's add the margin left 31 pixel. Now you can see the circle color is white and it is moving on the right side, but it is happening very quickly. So we have to add some transition also. So just come back and come here where we have added the button here. So here we will add the transition. Let's add transition background. Then we will add the time 0.5 seconds. We will add the same thing in this span. let's add a comma, and here we will add margin left because we are changing its position. For this one also we will add 0.5 seconds. After that, let's see, if we click here, you can see the button toggle very smooth. So this toggle button is working fine. Next we have to turn on and turn off this light. Right now the opacity is 0, so we will change the opacity to 1 whenever we will click on the button. So let's come back, come to the CSS file. At the bottom we will add another class name. Let's add class name on, and here we will add opacity. Let's add opacity 1. Come here where we have added the light. See, here we have the added CSS properties for the light. So here we will add transition, opacity 0.5 seconds. Now we will come to the JavaScript, and here we have to add that class name in the image, that is light. So let's add a ID here so that we can select this one easily. I will add the ID light. Duplicate this line, write the name light, and here also ID light. Copy this one, write this, then class list dot toggle, and in this toggle we will add that class name that we have written here, which is on. That's it. After applying this, let's click on this button, and you can see the light turns on. If we will click again, it turns off, and it is happening very smoothly. So finally we have completed this web page. I hope this video will be helpful for you. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section. Please like and share this video, and also subscribe my channel Easy Tutorials to watch more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching this video.